my basic flight plan is going to be here from Central Florida. I'm going to take off right out of Altamont Springs over here, out of a little lake. I'm going to head down to Melbourne over here, and then we're going to head out onto the wild ocean. And let me reduce that a little bit for you. You can get the scope of the flight. It's pretty far, especially when you're only traveling at about 90 miles an hour in a seaplane. I'm going to go over here to Nassau. Land, we'll have to check in the customs, and then all the way down here to this place called Turks and Caicos, which actually still belongs to the United Kingdom. And I'm sure if they raised a revolution and decided to declare independence, Britain would gladly give it to them. You know why? Because no one else wants it. And after that, I'm going to make a very long overwater flight. You can see there's Cuba down there, Havana, Dominican Republic. And I'm going to come down from Turks and Caicos all the way down to Puerto Rico. And then from Puerto Rico, I'm going to go to the United States, Virgin Islands. And then back to Puerto Rico. Let's see if we can pull up the U.S. Virgin Islands, which is called St. Thomas. And I'm going to be landing at a place called Charlotte Amalie. It used to belong to the Danes before Blackbeard the Pirate got there. Oh, yeah, there it is. Charlotte Amalie. That's where I'm going. And then I will make the way all the way back to Aguadilla, Puerto Rico, and then I will take off and fly all the way back to Turks and Caicos somewhere, if I can find it. And believe me, that's how it feels like in the air sometimes too. And instead of going to the Bahamas, I am going to try for a straight shot past the Bahamas, avoid all that crap, and go in to Miami. And once I'm in Miami, I'm going to just head straight up to actually I'm going to head up to Merrit Island. Right there is Merrit Island. I'm going to land on that little island. I've done it many times before. Little kind of little peninsula there, little island. And then I'll go back in to Altamont Springs. And that's going to be my flight. It's probably, I would say, 2,500 miles round trip. Go figure that out in kilometers. It's a lot. So, well, here I am at seaplane base, which is of course just my new friend's house, and then the seaplanes are in the back. Pretty cool. And in his backyard is all the airplanes. Awesome. Pretty daunting stuff flying across the Caribbean. And there's our life raft, some of the emergency equipment, and well, we decided to turn back because of a problem with the auxiliary fuel pump located in that left wing wasn't working, and we could have, you know, only thing that happens is
grabbed it with the paddle.
Yeah.
And it wouldn't start.
Which banged it with the paddle, it still wouldn't start. Oh.
Well, we're in the water. Cleaning off the weeds. Just making a little movie.
South Africa originally, but he's been in the United States for 17 years and this is permanent residence, right?
Never back, thank you. I'm still paying child support on that thing.
Yeah. We're going down and we'll
off to Bueno, Melbourne. Good.
Hello?
Officer Matos. Officer Matos.
Well, I couldn't resist putting the Bad Boys
NPC
song in there.
Yeah, he said he was an Air Marine.
This is the first time I've been stopped by customs while trying to leave the United States, and I'm going to the Caribbean. I mean, normally, you know, they search the plane when you're coming back from the Caribbean. I mean, what on earth am I going to take to the Caribbean when it's already there? Do you know what I'm talking about? Here's some pictures of Nassau and the Bahamas, and we landed over there. They were friendly for once. Nice helicopter that landed just before us. There's a
well, here's my
room.
Boudoir in Turks and Caicos. And anyway, I just miss home. That's all I'm gonna say. Whatever that is. I'm watching Jason Bourne, which kind of funnily, when I was coming to America from South Africa, I was reading this book, of the movie that's playing right now. I find that interesting. And here I am, stuck in transit somewhere, and doing it again.
And I think that was Frederick Forsyth's The Bourne Identity that I was reading when I came to the United States all those years ago. Some pictures there of the hotel in Turks and Caicos Islands. I didn't even go out there. It was so beautiful, though, but we had to leave. There's Hench catching some rays. Actually, the sun hadn't really come up. And our lovely pool that we didn't get to enjoy. And I was starving because I didn't have a wallet. And, they drive on the wrong side of the road, so it kind of reminded me back of home in Africa, some kind of way. This is the airport. It's me, classic pose. And that's, I guess we're just taking off out of Turks and Caicos right there. That beautiful water. That's the one thing they have going for them. The ocean around Turks and Caicos is that beautiful turquoise color. And one day I'd like to go there and do some diving. And some more pictures of the water. And now we're en route to Puerto Rico. Hinch looks happy. I'm looking down at something and I guess the camera went off. More pictures of the ocean. I can't tell you how beautiful it is. It's the most beautiful water I think I've ever seen. And I've seen some water. I guess there's some clouds. And this is more of Turks and Caicos. Clouds, Turks. And I don't know what those things are. Look like mud. Some kind of mud teardrop looking stuff that we saw in the ocean. And we're heading out to Puerto Rico, and there's Puerto Rico. And we're starting to look grim and determined because we'd radioed ahead to Puerto Rico to see if the fuel guy would go and get my wallet, which was FedExed to the hotel. And there he is. And believe me, customs wouldn't let me in. He talked to customs, got it sorted out, and they allowed me into the country without any credentials to go to my hotel. This is now going to St. Thomas on final approach at Charlotte Amalie. And, they have that runway that they've built out into the water. It's beautiful, especially if you do an approach at night. Nice water. This is St. Thomas Airport. That's Hench's butt. And we're waiting on the dog.
Well, here we are in St. Thomas again. And I guess you can remember all of the places. Our hotel was way up over there, remember? Nice little plane going up there. And now I really love it.